Did you know that every time you browse the web, send an email, or stream a video, your data flows through specific ports? These network ports act like doors, directing internet traffic to the right places. But most people don't even realize they exist. In this video, we'll break down what port numbers are, how they work, and why they matter in networking and online security. Without further ado, let's dive in. A port number is a numerical identifier assigned to specific processes or services on a device, helping computers and servers communicate over a network. Just like a building's address directs mail to the right location, a port number ensures that incoming and outgoing data reaches the correct application. Every online activity, whether browsing a website, sending an email, or transferring a file, uses a designated port number to streamline communication. For example, web traffic typically uses port 80 for HTTP or 443 for HTTPS, ensuring that browsers and web servers exchange information smoothly. Port numbers are always paired with an IP address, forming a structured format like this. Here, 80 specifies the service handling the connection. If you're not familiar with how IP addresses work, check out our separate video explaining them. Now that we know what port numbers are, let's see how they actually work in networking. Ports help computers and servers manage multiple network connections by ensuring data reaches the correct application. When a device sends a request, like loading a website or checking email, it includes a source port, assigned temporarily by the system, and a destination port, specific to the requested service, like 80 for HTTP. The receiving device uses this destination port to forward data to the right process, then responds using the sender's source port, keeping communication organized. Ports function at layer 4 of the OSI model, the transport layer, working with TCP and UDP to control data flow. If you're not familiar with the OSI model, we have a video explaining it. You can also check out our video on network protocols to learn more about TCP, UDP, and other network protocols. Now that we understand how ports work, let's go over some of the most commonly used ones. Out of the 65,536 port numbers available, only a handful are widely used for essential services. Port 80 for HTTP and port 443 for HTTPS handle web traffic. File transfers rely on port 21 for FTP and port 22 for secure transfers with SFTP and SSH. Email services use port 25 and port 587 for sending emails with SMTP, while port 143 and port 993 handle receiving emails with IMAP. The domain name system, or DNS, runs on port 53, helping convert website names into IP addresses. Other important ports include port 23, used for remote access with Telnet, though it's mostly replaced by SSH, and port 3389, which enables remote desktop connections. These well-known ports help keep the internet running smoothly, ensuring data reaches the right place. Now let's see how ports play a crucial role in both network security and cybersecurity. Firewalls help control access to ports, managing which connections are allowed or blocked. They act as gatekeepers, allowing or blocking traffic based on port numbers and predefined rules. For example, a firewall might block port 21 to prevent unauthorized FTP access or restrict port 3389 to limit remote desktop connections. Many firewalls use stateful packet inspection or SPI to monitor ongoing connections and ensure only legitimate traffic gets through. Closing unused ports reduces the risk of cyberattacks like port scanning and unauthorized access attempts. Firewalls are a key defense against threats like DDoS attacks and malware, which often exploit open ports. To learn more, check out our separate video on firewalls. And for a deeper dive into cyber threats, see our video on common cyberattacks. Now that we've seen how firewalls use ports for security, let's break down the different types of ports and how they are categorized. Well-known ports ranging from 0 to 1023 are reserved for essential services discussed in the previous chapters. Registered ports, ranging from 1024 to 49,151, are assigned to specific applications and services, such as database management or gaming servers. Dynamic or private ports, ranging from 49,152 to 65,535, are temporarily assigned by operating systems for client-side communications. Within this range, ephemeral ports are short-lived and automatically chosen for outbound connections, like the source port 49218 we saw earlier. These ports allow devices to establish multiple simultaneous connections without conflicts, automatically closing when no longer needed. Understanding these categories helps in network management, security configurations, and troubleshooting connectivity issues. Now that we've explored the different types of ports and their role in networking, let's see how you can check which ports are open on a device. One of the most widely used tools for this is Nmap, which scans for open ports and provides details about active services. For a quick check on Windows, you can use the netstat command in the command prompt with netstat-an to list active connections and their corresponding ports. On Linux and Mac OS, commands like ss-tuln or lsof-i can help identify open ports and their associated processes. Many online services also allow users to test open ports remotely by entering an IP address. Understanding open ports is important for both troubleshooting network issues and improving security by closing unnecessary ones. Now that we know how to check open ports, let's look at how they can be used to allow external access. Port forwarding is a technique that allows external devices to access services on a private network by directing traffic from a specific port on a router to a designated device. This is commonly used for hosting game servers, remote desktop access, and running web servers from home networks. When a request reaches the router on a forwarded port, it redirects the data to the appropriate internal IP address and port. However, improper configuration can expose a network to security risks, making it important to forward only necessary ports and use firewalls for protection. Many routers offer manual port forwarding settings, while UPnP or Universal Plug and Play can automate the process for some applications. Now let's discuss reserved and unassigned ports. Ports can be categorized as either reserved or unassigned, depending on whether they have been officially designated for specific services. Reserved ports are those assigned by the Internet Assigned Numbers Authority or IANA for well-known services, such as HTTP and DNS. These ports are typically standardized to ensure compatibility across networks. On the other hand, unassigned ports have not been officially designated for any specific use. They remain available for dynamic allocation by applications or private services. While some unassigned ports may later receive official assignments, others can be used freely by organizations and developers for custom networking needs. Understanding this distinction helps prevent conflicts and ensures efficient port management in networks. Next, let's take a look at port scanning and its role in ethical hacking. Port scanning is the process of scanning a network or device to identify open ports and services that may be available for communication. Ethical hackers use port scanning to assess the security of a network, identifying potential vulnerabilities that could be exploited by malicious actors. By scanning open ports, ethical hackers can uncover services that may be exposed or improperly secured, allowing organizations to address weaknesses before they are exploited. Tools like Nmap and other vulnerability scanners are commonly used in this process, helping security professionals evaluate the strength of firewalls and network defenses. It's important to note that while port scanning is a valuable technique for security testing, it should only be performed with permission, as unauthorized scanning can be considered illegal in many jurisdictions. In conclusion, ports are a fundamental part of networking, enabling communication between devices and services across the internet. From well-known ports used for essential protocols to dynamic ports that allow multiple connections, understanding how ports work helps in both troubleshooting and securing networks. Firewalls, NAT, and port forwarding all rely on ports to manage traffic efficiently, while ethical hackers use port scanning to identify vulnerabilities. Whether configuring networks, securing systems, or simply learning how data flows online, knowing about ports is essential for navigating the digital world. This marks the end of our exploration of network ports. If you found it helpful, consider subscribing to our channel and liking the video. Feel free to check out our other videos on related topics. Thank you for watching.